Welcome back to the channel, guys. And in today's video, we are going to shoutcast another battle set for you. And this is a pretty spicy team and a pretty high output damage as well, because it's rocking Shadow Electivire and Shadow Victory Bell. I'm not sure how damaging Shadow Victory Bell is in the Ultra League Premier, but still, I mean, it's Shadow Victory Bell, and I am expecting Swampert to get immediately deleted once it encounters it. And shout out to Devier and his son Tech for submitting these battles, and I hope you enjoy these battles. And shout out to Tech again, because this was a special request. So how are you doing, buddy? I hope you are doing good. And before we start with the team composition and the battles itself, if you are new to the channel, if you like our content, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. We are targeting to reach 500 subscribers by the end of February, so help us to reach that goal. And if you want to join the battle set Discord server, the link to that is in the description down below. Also, if you want to submit these battles for submit your battles for a shoutcast, the link to that is in the description down below. And moving on to the team composition now, the team he's running is Shadow Electivire, Shadow Victory Bell, as well as Mandibuzz. This Mandibuzz is not powered up all the way up to, like, this is not a completely XL Pokemon, but it's powered up to level 42. So it's going to be a bit bulky, but not up to its full potential. But Mandibuzz in Great League is also very bulky, so I think he has included Mandibuzz to have some bulk. This is a pretty spicy team indeed, because you will not see, I think Mandibuzz and Shadow Victory Bell are not that common, and Electivire also is not that common. I think it's, you can see here and there, but the primary electric type in the Ultra League Premier would be Ampharos and sometimes Magnezone. So team does okay on PV poke rating, and it's rated C in all the terms. I think bulk is C, because we have Shadow Electivire as well as Shadow Victory Bell, and Shadow Electivire I think is probably one of the squishiest Pokemon in the meta. But it will be interesting to see how this goes, and let's start with the battles to see how the battle goes. So picking up a positive lead here, but do need to watch out for a dynamic punch coming in from Poliwrath. But Poliwrath switch immediately, and in comes Gallade, to which he has an answer to in the form of this Mandibuzz. Let's see how much will a Leaf Blade, or they go for a Synchronize, which is definitely not the way to go. And he's also going for Foul Play, which does a lot of damage, by the way. But definitely you would want to go for an area Aerial Ace, because even though Aerial Ace is a terrible move, it would be super effective versus a neutral Foul Play. So he will take on another Leaf Blade, but Synchronize and Leaf Blade did almost equal damage, and Mandibuzz is a very tanky Pokemon, and I can only imagine what it will do once it gets to the complete level 50. And in comes Poliwrath. He is still going for Foul Play, so really not an optimal display. Now he's going for Aerial Ace. Maybe he doesn't want the opponent to know that he has an Aerial Ace. But yeah, this Mandibuzz will just go to town on this Poliwrath as well. And Poliwrath is already in yellow, and I don't think that Poliwrath can mud shot down Mandibuzz at this range. So they definitely would want to invest a shield, and this forces a swap out to Charizard, and they go for Foul Play. So this Mandibuzz has already put in a lot of work, and this Electivire will just, yeah, with shields down, I think the Electivire can just double shield the, I don't think the Charizard will be able to get to another charge move. So they go for a Wild Charge, which will definitely be able to take KO the Charizard. And he swaps to Victory Bell correctly, and it's a pretty insane swap as well, and this basically sealed the game, and Victory Bell will just come in and delete that Poliwrath. So he had, I think, all the, Poliwrath was basically just food for this team. I think every Pokemon can technically counter Poliwrath. So yeah, moving on to the next one, and in an Ampharos lead, so not a good lead I would say, but the Electivire is very spammy with the ice punches, and I don't think that or the opponent swaps out. Maybe they were running Focus Blast but wanted to preserve the energy, and they come in with Gengar. So this is the perfect opportunity for the Mandibuzz, because Shadow Punch, Shadow Ball will not do anything unless they are running Sludge Bomb. But I don't think a lot of people run Sludge Bomb in the Ultra League Premier. So farm down the Gengar completely, and he would definitely want to shield this Thunder Punch, because even though Mandibuzz is tanky, but Thunder Punch will hit coming in from Ampharos, but he is already at two Foul Plays. So going for foul play, this pressure the one shield of the opponent, and I think this foul play will pressure the another shield. So yeah, this team is like, this is working out better than I expected. So in comes Venusaur, and no need to watch out for Sludge Bomb coming in from Venusaur. I think Sludge Bomb would KO, but he shields the Sludge Bomb and goes for Sludge Bomb of his own, and I think this will, yeah, this does massive amount of damage, and he will be able to, yeah, Shadow Victory Bell is still OP in this league as well. So but I think it's not that OP, because we do have a lot of counters, I think Shadow Victory Bell is not that OP, but who knows, once XL Pokemons becomes a thing, then maybe you will be able to see a Grassole here as well. So picking up a neutral lead in the form of this Machamp, but the counter damage is really hurting, and the Thundershocks are not doing that much, but he will be able to spam those ice punches there, and he is going for a wild charge now onto the Snorlax, which takes half health off that Snorlax. So yeah, I'm really liking this team, but I really really wish I had an Electivire or a Shadow Victory Bell, or for that fact Mandibuzz as well, but really liking this team, to be honest. So he will be, yeah, tank superpower like anything. I think I have never gone so I have never enjoyed such video, I'm basically speechless. So farming down the Snorlax completely, and let's see what comes back in. So in comes Dragonite, and he go for an Aerial Ace, but I think foul play would have been the way to go. So going for Aerial Ace again, and definitely I think foul play would have been the way to go. Maybe he wanted to leave some energy of the Dragonite to farm from Electivire, but Electivire will not appreciate the Dragon Breaths. So again, going for Aerial Ace, this will really bring down the Dragonite very low, but I definitely think that I think that foul play was the way to go, and not, yeah. So going for shielding that Rock Slide, and will be able to complete, or almost was able to farm down the Machamp, and Shadow Victory Bell takes the Rock Slide comfortably, and this Leaf Blade will, yeah, this will take out the Dragonite. So yeah, really OP team. So 3-0, and he got pretty neutral leads. I think there was not, except for the first match, I think there both of the leads were pretty neutral. So moving on to the next one, in a Scizor lead. So again, this is a very neutral lead, and he is going for Ice Punch bait. Let's see if the opponent falls for it. So the opponent does not, which is not really good, but he will be able to get to another wild charge. And definitely this is most likely to crit the shield, or this Scizor will not shield. Scizor was very daring, but in comes Swampert. So going for Ice Punch here, and this will do some decent damage. And he has Shadow Victory Bell in the back, so he does not really care what the Swampert, if the Swampert farms a lot of energy or not. And yeah, I think Swampert is taking those Razor Leaves pretty well, because I think if it was Great League, two Razor Leaves would have just knocked that Swampert out, even from full health. So in comes Venusaur, and this I think this is game, right? Because Venusaur will only be able to throw the Sludge Bomb, and looking at the bulk of this Mandibuzz, I don't think Sludge Bomb will take 30%, but they end up baiting our man. But yeah, I think this is not really looking good for the opponent. So I think this is a Sludge Bomb, so definitely would want to shield this, and going for an Aerial Ace. Let's see how much damage it will do. I think it will not KO, because yeah, it does not even dent the Venusaur, considering it's an Aerial Ace, but able to catch on this charge move onto Victory Bell. This Devier is playing in some crazy plays here, because yeah, I for one am speechless, and the opponent just gives up. So going 4-0 until now, and I don't think that he got lucky with the leads except for the first one. Moving on to the next match, picking up a negative lead here, but the Venusaur would definitely want to shield an Ice Punch coming in from the Electivire. Looks like he does not want to shield. Maybe he does not want to give up switch advantage, because, or he does eventually. And in comes Togekiss. So this is not really looking good. I think he is getting hard countered now after 4-0. So, but it's the Mandibus is taking those chance pretty well. I can only imagine what Mandibus will do once it gets that complete level 50 boost and able to get to another aerial ace. This will chip down the I think this Togekiss is now in farm down range. Definitely would want to shield anything coming in from the Electivire, because you do not Electivire will not appreciate any charge move. In comes Venusaur. Unfortunately, Venusaur is able to throw before the Electivire got to throw the charge move. Going for an Ice Punch, and I think if it grabs a shield, or I think that was just a visual glitch, but in comes Swampert. Yeah, Swampert goes down pretty fast, but at least it's able to get to a charge move, unlike Great League or the Earthquake Registers. Oh my god. So going for an Ice Punch, I don't think this will get, this is definitely grabbing the shield, and the another Ice Punch, this will KO the Venusaur. So some crazy plays there, and I am genuinely amazed by these battles, and thank you Divya for submitting these. It was really great watching these battles as well. So again thanks for submitting these battles, and I hope all the viewers enjoyed watching this video as much as I did, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you for watching. Peace.